Thanks so much, Casey. For more on all this, let's bring in Texas Senator John Cornyn. He joins us this morning. Senator, good morning. Thanks for being here.
Good morning.
Always good to see you. All right, so let's look at some of these businesses that are reopening in Texas on Friday. You just heard it, retail stores, restaurants, movie theaters, libraries, even museums. Do you believe this is the right timing that Texas can reopen some of these businesses as soon as this week?
Well, Senator, there's no playbook for this. This is unprecedented, and I know Governor Abbott is consulting with the best minds, the experts, to try to guide his decision making. But to me, the key is nobody's forced to open up, but they can gradually, subject to these guidelines. And we're going to then hit the pause button, see how it's going before we proceed to open up some more. But nobody believes we can stay locked down and hunkered down in our homes, isolated forever.
And of course, we heard from Governor Abbott as well that while some of those businesses will reopen, and also the museums and libraries, social distancing measures will need to continue to take place. Those that operations that will not reopen are gyms, barbershops, hair salons, bars, tattoo parlors. So what, Senator, criteria do you think needs to be met in order to decide, okay, phase two, let's start opening some of these other businesses?
Well, I believe that the reason we did the initial lockdown is primarily to protect our hospitals from getting overrun with COVID-19 patients. So they were told no elective surgery. You have to leave your beds open. You have to leave your ICU available, and as well as ventilators. Now that it looks like these mitigation efforts have bent the curve, I think the governor is wisely, and our mayors are doing the same thing at the local level, trying to see, okay, can we take a first step? Can we stick our big toe in the water and see how that works? I think we're going to be guided by what the experience is and what the reaction is, because obviously public health, public safety comes first.
Next, the question becomes those small businesses that have not been able to make it through this, that are continuing to struggle, and especially those that haven't been able to reopen or won't this week. Here's a FoxBusiness.com article on stimulus phase four. You've heard a lot of the talk about it, Senator. Coronavirus stimulus phase four could exceed $1 trillion and include negative payroll tax. Would you be able to support that? And do you think it's got a chance at passing?
Sandra, I think it's premature to consider what additional steps we might take, because we've just spent roughly $2.8 trillion. And as you might expect, anytime you do anything this big and this fast, and again, this is unprecedented, there's going to be some bumps, there's going to be some problems. So what I'd like to do is see how well what we've already done meets the need, and then be guided by what we learn. I think it's premature to talk about $1 trillion more added to the national debt.
Got it. Meanwhile, Mitch McConnell has been getting some criticism for comments that he made suggesting bankruptcy for some states rather than federal bailouts. The president also agreeing with that, questioning in a tweet, why would we bail out some of these states that were already struggling before this hit? Governor Jay Inslee from Washington is the latest to criticize that suggestion from Mitch McConnell. Let's listen together and I'll get your reaction.
We are hopeful that Congress will roundly reject Senator McConnell's suggestion that the way to deal with this is to allow states go bankrupt. That is the most wrong-headed, ludicrous idea I've heard for a long, long time.
So, Senator, what was your reaction to that suggestion from Mitch McConnell?
Well, I think it was largely, unfortunately, misinterpreted. I think what Senator McConnell was trying to say, or what he did say, is there are limits to the extent the federal government can pay the bills for state and local government. They are, states are sovereign. They have their own tax base. They have their own budgets. And some states we know are notoriously bad about not balancing their budgets and having large unfunded public sector union pension plans, for example. We are more than happy to do what's necessary to deal with this virus. This is an emergency. That's why you've seen this unprecedented financial support for states and local government. But at some point, we're going to have a serious conversation about what those limits are, because the federal government can't continue to spend money and not add to our national debt and deficits, because that in and of itself can create a dangerous situation.
Well, Senator Cornyn, that is a debate surely that we will see continue to heat up in Washington, among other things, including another possible round of stimulus. Our best to your state. We will be watching closely as things start to reopen there in Texas, and we hope to have you back soon, Senator. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.